Scientists from China have achieved a breakthrough in engine development. They have developed a so-called thermoacoustic Stirling engine. It is said to be extremely quiet and virtually wear-free. The technology behind it has been known for some time. However, the new development is probably significantly more powerful than all the previous engines of this type. And this could mean major progress for space travel and military technology. In this video, we will find out what the thermoacoustic Stirling engine is all about, why it could be the future of space travel, and why Stirling engines haven't caught on yet in this video. And I say welcome to the German Science Guy. My name is Jacob, and in Germany we say los geht's. The basic technology behind the Stirling engine is actually very old. In 1816, the 26-year-old Robert Stirling invented the Stirling engine in Scotland. At that time, there were many steam engines and they were under high pressure. As a result, steam boilers kept exploding. There were so many fatalities that Germany even kept its own statistics according to which several hundred people died as a result of the boiler. Robert Stirling therefore wanted to develop a machine that would make work easier and above all safer. And so the Stirling engine was born. Scientists from China have now further developed the Stirling engine. The researchers refer to this as a thermoacoustic Stirling engine. Before we get to the advantages of this, let's first take a look at how a Stirling engine actually works. I had a model of a Stirling engine as a child and was really enthusiastic about it. The great thing about this is that the technology behind this is actually quite simple. The engine mainly consists of two pistons. These are the displacement piston and the working piston. And they work in one cylinder. The cylinder is divided into two chambers in which there is a gas, for example helium, or in this case simply air. These spaces have different temperatures. So there's a cold and a warm space. The heat for the warm room is generated by an external heat source such as my teacup. So when I start the engine, it keeps moving. In the hot room, the gas heats up and expands. The expanding gas now pushes the working piston away because the working piston moves. The flywheel also moves. The flywheel is also connected to the displacement piston. This also causes it to move. And when the displacement piston moves, it pushes the gas back from the hot to the cold area. It then cools down and is compressed. The displacement piston also serves as a regenerator. For example, it absorbs heat from the gas between the phases and releases it back into the gas. This preheats it and the cycle starts all over again. So the basic mode of operation of the thermoacoustic Stirling motor actually differs somewhat from conventional ones. It is based on a phenomenon from thermoacoustics, namely that thermal energy generates sound waves or vice versa. The principle has been known for a long time, and as early as the late 1970s, scientists recognized that sound waves moving in a gas along a heat exchanger can go through a cycle similar to that of a Stirling engine. This means that the changes in pressure and speed of the gas in which the waves move are very similar. And the scientists are taking advantage of this. The piston is to be driven with the help of these sound waves, which then produce electricity. The gas used in the new development is highly compressed helium with a pressure of 15 megapascal, which is more than 30 times the pressure on a bicycle tire. In addition to the piston and the cylinder, there will now also be a magnet and a coil, which of course sounds like a generator. The South China Morning Post reported on the Stirling engine. According to them, NASA is currently working on an engine that should function very similar. NASA also provides a little more information on how it works, which could actually provide some insights into the Chinese development. According to NASA, the motor contains a magnetic material that is deformed by the sound waves. In other words, the material expands and contracts, so to speak, but the whole thing only happens in the micrometer range. And this actually allows electricity to be produced. The magnet is located in a coil, and the deformation of the magnet also changes its magnetic field. And as we all know, a changing magnetic field induces a current in a coil. In fact, unlike NASA, the Chinese scientists have already built a prototype. According to them, the Stirling engine is the most powerful of its kind ever built. It is said to have an output of 102 kilowatts. This is also the first time we got above this 100 kilowatt mark. The researchers used a 530 degrees Celsius heat source for this. 28% of the thermal energy can be converted into electrical energy. With a 600 degrees Celsius heat source, this could even be 34%. In fact, there are already Stirling engines with an efficiency of over 30%, and in some cases, even up to 40%. But the output has so far been far below 100 kilowatt. So if the engine from China actually has this output, that would be very impressive. Compared to other generators, however, this is of course not that much, so why is it still quite exciting? Let's take a look at other advantages offered by the thermoacoustic Stirling engine. The biggest advantage is probably that there are hardly any moving parts. As a result, it is said to be extremely quiet and almost vibration-free. However, I couldn't find an exact specification of how loud it is in the end. One big advantage, however, is that because there are hardly any moving parts, maintenance is almost never necessary. Only one piston moves in the engine from China, but there should be very little space between this piston and the cylinder. Only a single hair should fit between them. This creates an almost airtight space, but still nowhere due to friction. Thanks to the few moving parts, the service life is probably more than 10 years. Now, of course, the question is, what areas of application the engine offers. Because the motor is so quiet, it could be used in submarines, especially in the military sector. It is simply much more difficult to detect quiet submarines with sonar. That's why the volume is definitely relevant in this area. In fact, Stirling engines are already being used in submarines in Sweden. The development from China is comparatively powerful. It could therefore bring major advances in military technology. Another interesting area of application is space travel. The decay of radioactive particles could serve as a heat source here. In fact, sensors and smaller technical applications are already supplied with energy in this way. If you want so, I can make a video about the nuclear battery. It's very interesting technology. Let's get back to the engines. If you manage to increase their performance and efficiency, such motors could perhaps make an important contribution to new projects, for example, a lunar station. Such motors simply last an extremely long time and require little maintenance. But although Stirling engines have been around for quite a long time and offer so many advantages, they have not yet been able to establish themselves. Let's take a look at the reasons for this and the big but or the big problem. However we call it, we still have to find a way for this. Oh, and one important note, if you don't want to miss any more videos in the future, click on subscribe and activate the bell. In fact, there are some applications for Stirling engines, for example in space travel or in submarines, so they are already being used, just not on such a large scale. In many areas, for example, they have not prevailed over combustion engines. There are several reasons for this. First of all, a 100 kilogram combustion engine, for example, always produces more power than a 100 kilogram Stirling engine. It is therefore significantly more powerful for the same weight. In addition, the change in output cannot be controlled as easily as with combustion engines. This makes them much more difficult to use in cars, for example. In addition, they are still very expensive. And another reason is their interest in Stirling engines was very low for a long time because combustion engines developed so quickly. However, interest in these engines seems to be growing again as shown by developments in China. Another problem, another but, is the little information that can be found, which is simply due to the field of application of the thermoacoustic Stirling engine. As I said, its properties make it very interesting for military use. And that is also the reason why there are so little information and hardly any sources on the engine. This makes it very difficult to classify this technology. For example, there is no information on how it works exactly or how loud it is. Nevertheless, I find the technology very exciting and promising. Even after more than 200 years, research is still being carried out. That already shows the great potential that is seen in it. And I believe that the development from China is a very important step in research into this technology. Now, feel free to write in the comments what you think about the engine and the whole technology. For me, it's still, it's like magic, but magic that works, so it is science. So I say goodbye or auf Wiedersehen. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Your Jacob.